Hello everyone, my name is Jeff Dumert. I'm a business development executive with MentorWorks. Thanks for the opportunity to speak today. Today's focus will just be on a high-level overview of the top funding programs available. I'll give a quick overview of our company and our services, but the focus will be on the informative side of things with the government funding programs. Here at MentorWorks, we have 22 funding specialists. We have an extremely high success rate. Over 86% of all of the funding applications we write are approved. We write 75 unique different funding programs. And since inception, we've received over $1.5 billion for our clients. Our average client is receiving around $176,000 in grants, non-repayable funding, while repayable loans generally at 0% are being recouped around $2.4 million per client. What makes MentorWorks different? Among our peers, we have the most experience through volume of applications. Last year, we wrote over 900 different funding applications. We have the largest number of funding programs served. So as mentioned previously, we write over 75 different unique funding programs. We have great relationships with program managers. This allows us to reach out to them quickly to get prompt replies if we need to know more information about a particular program, or if we want them to pre-screen a particular application or project to make sure it's a good fit. We have those relationships to do so. We understand when and how to appeal certain applications, and we have the ability to meet time pressing intake deadlines. There's four different areas of government funding. I won't go through all of these today. The focus will be on the capital investments and the hiring and training opportunities. So commercialization and capital investments. The Jobs and Growth Fund, this is a relatively new program offered through FedDev. The idea behind this program is for larger scale expansion projects or capital investments. The program will fund up to 50% of project costs to a maximum of $10 million as a zero interest loan. For the duration of the project, there is no repayment. Once the project is completed, you'll have between 5 to 7 years to pay back that loan, again at 0%. Some of the biggest drivers here that this program is looking at to become a strong application is job creation. Everyone knows that the economy was hit hard through COVID, so really they want to promote this program to bring back as many jobs as possible. In addition to this, they're looking at other factors, including projects that would be environmentally friendly, reducing your carbon footprint. They're also looking at projects that foster an inclusive recovery plan, as well as projects that are adopting Industry 4.0 practices. This is one of the few programs that will allow you to go retroactive to April 19th. The spend must be completed by the end of March 2024. The Southwestern Ontario Development Fund or Eastern Ontario Development Fund, same program, just depends on where you're located. The GTA is not included within these two programs. So looking at roughly around Guelph, Cambridge area down towards Windsor, as well as eastern towards Port Colborne, all the way up towards Ottawa. This program is a little bit unique in the sense that it depends on how many people live in your community to determine what you receive back through this program. So if you're in a non-rural community, you receive 15% of eligible expenses as a loan, up to $5 million, so a zero interest loan, with 30% of that forgiven to a maximum of $500,000 if you meet your project impacts. If you're in a rural community, so under 100,000 people in your community, as well as under 100 full-time employees, you can receive up to 15% grant. So it's non-repayable up to a max of $500,000. This program can be stacked with the previous one. Similar impacts they're looking at. They do want to still see the job creation upwards of 5 for rural communities and upwards of 10 for the non-rural. They're also looking at innovation as well as productivity improvements through leasehold improvements or capital investments. This is an intake basis program, so every quarter there is a new intake. This next intake is coming up December 17th, so it's only a few weeks away. It does require the approval before you can start the project, so you'd be looking at March 18th before you can kick off the project. The Ontario Automotive Modernization Program. So this program has been out before. It is relaunching on November the 15th. The benefit here is that it has increased the maximum grant amount you can receive back. So it recovers 50% of eligible cost to a maximum of $150,000. This program is specific to companies in the automotive sector. You must be a manufacturer, have less than 500 employees in Ontario, less than $1 billion in consolidated global revenues, and at least 2 years of financial statements. Great program if you're looking to acquire new software or new ERP. ERP is one of the few programs that does cover the actual ERP implementation cost. In addition to this, it will cover some of the hardware, so any monitors you might have to receive in the shop floor, if there's new software that requires scanners, that is something that could be included. It does not cover capital equipment, so just want to be very clear there. The other opportunity here is if you're looking to implement lean practices, so hire a consultant to help implement more lean initiatives, this is a great program for that as well. And it doesn't have to be one or the other, it could be a combination of the two. Hiring and training incentives. So these are probably the most popular programs I see. They don't have as many of the restrictions in terms of eligibility. So two options right now. The first is for interns or co-op students. It covers 75% of their wage up to $7,500. This changes throughout the year depending on what program is available. Some programs look at specific roles that you'd be hiring for. So for instance, technical or digital roles, while other programs look at environmental related roles. So the post-secondary young graduates, the only program open now is for environmental related programs or roles that you'd be filling, covering 80% of their wages to a maximum of $25,000. Canada Ontario Job Grant. So this is a very popular program. It's been around for 6+ years now. This is a program that would cover any third party related training cost. Up to 50% if you have over 100 employees, up to 83% if you're less than 100 employees, to a maximum of $10,000 per trainee. This program only covers the training, so if you're looking at, say, an ERP project, for example, it does not cover any of the ERP implementation costs. In addition, if the vendor doing the training is also selling the software, it's considered a product vendor, which is ineligible. We have had success getting ERP projects or ERP training funded. So if you want more details on that, please reach out to me at the end of this. This program also requires the approval before you start the training. So on average, we're seeing about a 4-week turnaround time from the time you submit it until the time you're approved. Another training incentive program, the Ontario Manufacturers Training Program. It is expected to launch over the next month or so. It previously covered 25 to 50% of eligible training costs to a maximum of $100,000. ERP and software related training costs are eligible. They're not as strict in terms of what is classified as a product vendor. If you have applied for it previously, you're subject to 25%. If you're a new applicant, you receive up to 50% of costs. Again, both to a max of $100,000. Yeah. That is subject to change. So once the program does open up, we'll have more details on what the actual terms are. Another great thing with this program is it does cover not only the third-party training expenses, but also any internal training, as well as the employees' wages while they're being trained. So we see a lot of companies taking advantage of this for cross-training, management training, lean training, anything that will improve productivity. And one final program is Can Export. It's scheduled to open up again in January 2022. This is for companies that are looking to increase their export sales. It'll cover 50% of the eligible cost to a maximum of $50,000. So popular projects we see are any online marketing initiatives, email campaigns, other social media campaigns, SEO related costs, working with third-party consultants to come up with market strategies. It will also cover now, new to 2022, is in-person trade shows as well as business travel to help grow those expert sales. Previously, that was eliminated due to the travel restrictions in place. And that is it. I just want to touch on a couple of programs here. I don't have a lot of time, but if you do want to get an extensive overview of what's available to your company, feel free to reach out to myself. We offer a free complimentary one-on-one meeting. Or if you have any general questions, you can just shoot me an email as well. Thanks again, and have a great day.